guys, how are you? It's Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training, and I'm really excited about this next video. It's from my Seattle, Washington seminar. It's a kennel up video. This is a dog that at the seminar would not go into a crate. It fought the owner. It tried to bite the owner. It sort of redirected on the owner. It put the brakes on, made a lot of noise, a lot of objections. Keep in mind, we see dogs that will put the brakes on, jump on top of the crate, around the crate, crocodile roll, bite the owner, bite the leash, scream and yell, all for not going in the crates. This concept that we can make the crate more inviting, throwing in a stuffed Kong, throwing in kibble, they don't care. Making the crate more inviting, they don't care. Being patient, take your time. How much time? Like, we have to go to bed, we have to go to work. It's a safety protocol for most of these dogs to have them out of the crate unattended, and they need to go in there. So you have to be able to get the dog in the crate safely and efficiently. But what you're going to see is a dog in real time go from seconds prior to this, it didn't want to go in, to us going in. So how do we set it up? There's a long line on the dog connected to the collar that goes through the back of the crate. The person in the back is actually the one doing most of the pulling. I'm just walking up looking normal. Because at some point, what happens is, if I try to reach my arm in, I can't go in any farther. Also, it's the safest way to do it because the dog can easily redirect. So, are we using force? Absolutely. The cool part is, what, 3-4 repetitions of force? We'll get a dog that will then will just walk right in. We see it all the time. The goal is that you just teach this dog a new word, kennel up, the dog will go in. Every single time. They go from sometimes months or years of never being allowed to be crated up to 3 to 5 minutes, and it lasts, and it works at the house, it works on all different kennels. So if you're a dog trainer with a dog coming into your dog training facility, if you just adopt a dog, you're bringing home a new dog, whatever the situation is, you just want to start crating your dog, and you've owned the dog for a while, this is a great way to do it. It's quick, it's efficient, it's safe. But you're also going to see a dog that's not thrilled. You're going to see a dog that's not excited about this. It's like, oh well, you know, I mean, sorry, but we're not excited about your behavior outside of the crate. And we're not excited about you destroying things, soiling things. And we're not excited about you, you know, eating things that cost us expensive surgery. You have to kennel up. And the concept that, well, you know, be patient, wait a little bit. It's like, you don't need to. There's no reason you need to do it. You will get a dog that will not go in a crate to go in a crate happily. Not all that thrilled about it right in this video, but give it a watch. It's very, very quick. It's very, very efficient. And you'll see exactly. When you're going to see some laughter, nobody's laughing at the dog not loving the experience, guys. Nobody's laughing at dogs at my seminar. You have to remember this is a 18-hour seminar. You've got to bring it all into context there. We have a good time there, but the content is really, really serious. So enjoy. Thank you so much for watching. And these are all done at my seminar. Whatever you're struggling with, we accomplish. No matter how difficult the dog is, we just do it hands-on in the trenches. So enjoy. Thank you guys so much. Bye.
And ready? And let's go. So here we go. So now, step two is, can there slack on the leash? So now, same thing. We open up, we close, we open up. Okay, he's actually went backwards. Cool. So we had a meaningful conversation. We go like this, and break. The big thing is right now, is when he comes out of the crate, is to pop him into a sit. Do it again. Let's go.
I thought Mike was better now.
And here we go. And try to do, try a little bit, we'll try to loosen up each time to see if he starts doing better.
Okay.
And let's go.
Yeah. I had nothing.
Good. So you had nothing at all?
Nothing.
Okay, so, and I didn't use any leash pressure at all.
So wants to get away from
that. So normally the second time, you're definitely doing some leash pressure, but it's always not as much.
It's always not as much.
So, again, we open up the door, and break. I like the slowness that he comes out, mm-hmm. And I like that.
Way softer.
As funny as that is, I actually don't want that. So, Jeff, it works, but now he won't come out of the crate. So, break. We'll still leave that out just in case we need it. And so now I'm going to give it a word. Yep. So now what I'm going to do is, let's see, I'm going to put him into an SIT because he likes to object to that. So Grady's not doing that now. And again, and think about where my body is. Like, I'm setting my body up the same way every time. Why? Dogs see things in pictures sometimes. So it's like, yeah, this all looks the same. Like, if I was on that side, it probably wouldn't go all the way back to like the first time, but it looks different. So guys, do like literally do the same thing. And then obviously you can mix it up. But I don't know if it's gonna matter, because pretty soon I'll be sitting down in that chair and I'll say kennel up and my dog will run in the kennel. It doesn't make a difference where you are. I'll be able to yell downstairs, kennel up, and my dog will run into the kennel. And when I switch to remote collar, it's like kennel up, pressure, dog gets in. So now we'll go like this, kennel up, and good, and then good. Okay, good. So then again, this. Now I'm making this sort of easy. I'm standing right here. And I'm not gonna do this right now, but I want this crate to be open and I wanna be standing away from it. I'm definitely sort of blocking the dog from rushing out. I want that dog to know it cannot come out until it hears a command. And that command is break. But again, slower. It's like, we'll do drivey stuff outside. We'll play chuck it, we'll play fetch. We'll do all the fun stuff outside. This, calm it down. Number one, you're too big of a dog to be moving fast around humans. I just say, kennel up. And good. And close the door. So absolutely forceful first, so we can get here. Because there's no sort of luring system or anything else that you're gonna do that's gonna want this dog to go in that crate.